Welcome back, everybody. Your next comedian was born in Sheffield, Great Britain. He now makes his home here in Vancouver. Please welcome Simon King.
I'm Simon King. I hope you like bridges, because welcome to Bridge Chat. Nothing makes you want to become a stand-up comic. Comedy club owners travel around in a van, and then they go into bars where people are drunk, and they hit them over the head, and you wake up with a mic in your hand. I've been doing stand-up comedy long enough that I don't really have any friends anymore, or credit rating, or prospects. I really painted myself into a corner that long. How would I describe my stand-up comedy style? It's sort of like, you know how some comics, they're like snipers and they have like one joke and they pick out a target and they fire? I'm kind of like that guy jumping out of a flaming car with two handguns. I don't hit that much, but it's really cool to watch. Who would I say is the greatest comic of all time? Gandhi's got some good stuff. He did some interesting stuff with all that character work and the starvation and stuff. That was kind of neat. Hitler was a little dark and edgy. Comic. Why am I gonna win this competition? I think you have too much faith in me. Quite frankly, I think I'm gonna show up because I heard there were sandwiches. Do I have a strategy for the competition? I don't know if you've noticed, I have a beard. I don't know what else I really can do. I mean, it's like I actually have a beard. It's showing up, right? Like, yeah. What would I do with $10,000? I think we all know it's gonna be some sort of flesh-eating gold robot with laser eyes. I mean, I think that's pretty much what everyone. I'm coming for you, Bond. I'm seriously coming for you. Seriously, you should look out.
Hey guys, all right. Before we get going, I have to apologize because I know a lot of you came here expecting llama fisting material. That's why you came to a comedy show, to see material about fisting llamas. You're like, I'm sick of watching comedy at home on television where they censor all the high quality llama fisting material. I'm going out to see live stand-up to see material about fisting llamas. I paid my money, you say, to see high quality llama fisting material, and that's what I demand. Well, I have to apologize because I don't have any llama fisting material. I don't. The best I can give you is this. If that's not enough. If that is not enough, then ask for your money back because it's the best you're gonna get. I was on the bus recently because things are going great in my life. And thanks. And this crazy guy got on the bus. And he's that sort of crazy where he gets his own section of the bus. You know, that sort of crazy. He's like, I'm gonna wear you as a suit. That sort of crazy, right? And he gets on the bus and he's going crazy and everyone gets up and moves to the back of the bus because we're Canadian and afraid of things. So we're like, okay, well, this is not happening. So he's at the front of the bus just going crazy. And he sits in that seat next to the bus driver while the crazy, lonely people sit, and he's just going up. And I had this weird instinct, and I don't know what it is, and I don't know why, but I got up and I sat right next to him. Yeah. So he's like, and I'm like, shh. And he went to sleep. And that's when I realized, guys, I'm a fucking bum whisperer. That's what I do. That's my gift, yeah. Crazy. There's crazy everywhere. I saw this on the news. This guy's walking his dogs in the woods. About 100 yards away, sees a bear. Now, he doesn't know what I would do when I see a bear, which is shit my pants and pass out, right? Yogi. This guy, he sees a bear and something goes snap in the old noodle box. I don't know what's going on in this man's life, but instead of running away, this guy sees a bear and he's like, let's do this. Listen to me when I tell you this, because this is absolutely true. This man beats a bear to death with his bare hands. Think about that for a second. I know there's a lot of tough guys in here with chains over their t-shirts and affliction hoodies who could turn me inside out and use me as sock puppets. I don't give a fuck how tough you think you are, haircut. This is a bear, okay? It could be like UFC 155, Silva versus Bear. Get it on. Pfft, bear wins. You know why? It's a fucking Buick with teeth. That's why. And this guy beat it to death with his bare hands. Everybody's like, whoa, it wasn't with his bare hands. He had a stick. Oh, that's even more impressive because that means he had the presence of mind to go, I'm gonna need this. He beat a bear to death with his bare hands. It's even more impressive because it was a black bear, so it probably had a gun. This guy beat a bear to death. What? And he did it in front of its kids. That's Russian mob shit, man. You learn a lesson, stupid bear bullshit. Bear. He beat a bear to death, and then it took him 2.5 hours to walk back to town. Do you know why? His humongous balls. That's why. Congratulations, sir. You're the best person ever. You beat a bear to death. That's carte blanche for the rest of your life. That's your voicemail message. That's your business card. That's your Facebook status. Hey, not qualified for the job you want? Who gives a shit? Write that on a paper page or slide it across the table. Watch him try to turn you down. I'm sorry, you're not close to qualified for beat a bear to death with a... Is this true? Yeah, it is. Congratulations, Mr. President. Like, what the fuck? If McCain beat a bear to death, he'd be president right now. What's Obama gonna do? I'll strangle a raccoon. It's not even gonna happen. And I like Obama, too. I like Obama because I like to say Obama. Obama! Obama! I use it like hello. Obama, Dave! Obama, Mom, drive safely. At you, Barack you. I like it. And I was watching the news and the guy's talking about Obama and he says, only in America could there be a black president. What about Africa, fucktard? What about there, huh? They're just bussing some guy in from Iowa. Everyone, this guy's name is Larry. He's going to help us run the Congo. Like, what the fuck? I appreciate you're proud of yourself. America wanted to go to war with Canada over the Arctic. Did you know that? Really? You want to fight Canada in the snow? You want to do that? We'll arm ourselves a Canadian tire. It'll be over in 20 fucking minutes. You know what I mean? Oh, you can't see? Should have got some minus 40 washer fluid, you dumb motherfucker. Turn into the skid. Well, your tank doesn't work because you didn't plug it in last night. You got to plug in your tank. They got more soldiers than us, but we got healthcare, so we can fix ours faster, get them back out there, right? And they got more guns, but we fight hockey style. It's hard to aim with a jersey over your fucking head. That's all I'm saying. Roll up the rim and lose, motherfucker. Fight with Canada. We got guys who beat bears to death. What are you, nuts? They like to call themselves the greatest country in the world, America. Greatest country in the world! But 55 million people don't have health insurance. You can go to jail for 30 years for an ounce of marijuana. That's not the greatest country in the world. You gotta just say it. You gotta prove it. That's like me going, six-pack abs! It's not true. You gotta do it. They had a woman running for Senate in the States. Her name was Christine O'Donnell. She was running on the principle of banning pornography. Ban porn? You think you got a lot of guys living in the woods with guns now. Take porn off the table. Watch as a... Have you ever hung out with a guy who hasn't had a chance to empty the storeroom for a couple of weeks? They get twitchy and stabby and murdery. Why do you think terrorism always comes from countries where there is no porn? Let me get this straight. It's hot as fuck. I can see this much of a woman and I have an AK-47. Oh, that'll end fine. That's why terrorism never comes from like northern countries, Scandinavia, because as soon as Sven starts to get twitchy about the government, you send him down the red light district and he gets tugged off by a girl with crazy forearm strength and low self-esteem. All of a sudden, those traffic cameras ain't that big a deal. You want to curb terrorism, carpet bomb Fallujah with some girl-on-girl DVDs. That shit's gonna calm right down. I would love to take part in the fatwa, but this scene with a shampoo bottle will blow your mind, and then I'm gonna need a nap. My name's Simon King, and I... Simon King, everybody!
How's the game going out there?
Oh, it's good. You know, they're tough, but you know, it's like we knew it coming in, and we were all like ready for it, and we were all talking before, and we were like, yeah. So you know, we're just putting our effort out, just really trying to work together, trying to as a team be cohesive. You know.
I'm not a fan of what I do, so it really to me. And everyone's like, oh, the classic damage comic. No, I've seen my act a lot, and you know, you just do what you can on the night at the time, and you just play to the crowd what you want to do. It's all the time aspect of it, so I'm far too grumpy and old to be to be organizing myself. But it's a good fun. It's a lot of fun.
So. How's the crowd?
They're good. They're great. They're sharp. They're on board with everything. I mean, it's always weird when you put cameras in a room and it throws an audience off a bit, but they seem to be pretty good. My best bit for me was when I'm like, oh, I made it on time. So that was my best part. And then I'd be like, oh, and then there's beer. So and I try not to think about stuff I've done because, like I said, I never like what I do. So I always look back at it and go, oh, you should have done this. You should have done that. But self-flagellation has to wait till later. So it's always good when a bunch of talented comics get together and do a show, and I think the real winners are the audience, so.